opera. Hold up your dresses and jump out quickly.
Ladies, welcome to the opera.
Bare arms and shoulders, brilliant uniforms, pearls and silk glittering before our eyes. Feminine envy, a whole crowd of memories, desires and emotions. Natasha, smooth your gown.
Natasha, smooth your gown.
Hear me, Michael Kirillovich has grown still stouter.
There's Boris and Julie engaged, and Anna Mikhailovna, what a headdress she has on.
And is that Natasha?
And is that Natasha?
And is that Natasha?
They're looking at me, they're talking about me. They all like me so much, the women envious, the men calming their jealousy.
Announcing Fedya Tolokov. He dominates Moscow's most brilliant young men. He stands in full view, well away, he's attracting attention, yet as much at ease as though he were in his own room.
Tolokov was in the Caucasus and he killed the Shah's brother. Now all the Moscow ladies are mad about him. Tolokov, the assassin.
Announcing Countess Helene Bezukhova, the queen of society, beautiful belly clothed, plump bare shoulders and much exposed neck, round which she wears a double string of pearls.
Helene and Tolokov on and on, Pierre the cuckold sits at home, Pierre the cuckold sits at home, the poor man.
No, I am enjoying myself at home this evening.
Countess Bezukhova, Pierre's wife. Have you been here long? And where is dear Pierre? He never used to forget us.
Yes, Pierre, that good man, a little sad, a little stout. He must come visit us.
I will implore him to do so.
There's a woman one should stay far away from. Now, Natasha, the curtain rises.
The curtain rises.
Everyone in the boxes and the stalls became silent. All the men, old and young, in uniform and evening dress. All the women in the hall with gems on their bare flesh turned their whole attention with curiosity to the stage. actors moving and singing so strangely in the lights, so false and unnatural. I'm ashamed and amused, and everyone else seems oblivious. Yes, everyone feigns delight.
And feeling the flood of brilliant lights, the warm perfumed air heated by the crowd, Natasha, little by little, began to pass into a of cold air. An exceptionally handsome man walked in with a confident yet courteous air. This was Helene's brother, Anatole Kragin. He moved with a swagger which would have been ridiculous had he not been so good looking. And though it was the middle of the act, he walked right down the aisle, his sword and spurs jangling, his handsome perfumed head held high. And he looked right at Natasha.
Mais charmant.
And he took his place in the front row next to Dolokhov. How handsome he is. How intoxicating.
In the second act, there were tombstones, the moon over the footlights, horns and contrabass, black cloaks and daggers in their hands.
I turn around again and our eyes meet. He gazes straight into my eyes. He is talking about me.
Candles burning, a crimson throne, the star wails a mournful tune. They all wave their arms and everybody cheers, bravo, bravo.
Every time I look at him, he's looking at me. Every time I look at him, he's looking at me. Every time I look at him.
A terrible noise, a clatter in the crowd, a storm of chromatic scales and diminished sevenths. With rapturous faces, everyone was shouting, screaming.